All right, welcome to this short demo of our process mining integration within Qlik Sense. Today I want to go through our report, our template report, and yeah, tell you a little bit about the capabilities and what you can do with our process mining solution. Okay, so as we see, we have a order to cache process within this demo. We have two main process variants, and we see that we have this one variant where we are working with inquiries and quotations, going through orders, order confirmations, and then we have shipment and hopefully invoicing and payment at the end. The second main process variant is the one where we have the process starting with and directly with an order, with call of order and call of confirmations, and then shipment, invoice, and payment again. As we look into the process, as I just stated, these two process variants are the ones that we are looking at the moment. We can always go ahead and show more or less activities and transitions. So we see that we have these two sliders here. So, okay, we want to show more activities or more transitions. Let's go ahead and say we care about all activities that we have within the process. Then this will show all of the activities that we have with the minimum needed amount of transitions, so the most frequent transitions for these activities here. So let's stay in this view because, I mean, this is quite nice. We see the full process with, yeah, like I said, the most frequent path. Maybe I will also go ahead and switch from a duration view to a frequency view so that we see where we have the most paths, where the most of the orders are going through. And I have this path here in mind where we have the call of confirmation to shipment. We see that it exists in 42% of the cases. We have average duration of 3 months and 3 weeks. Frequency of 711 as you see here. And I mean, 3 months to 3 weeks average is quite a lot. So what I want to do is I want to filter based on this transition. So I select it and say, okay, including this transition, I will see that the cases go down. The duration goes quite up because, yeah, this path here when going through the call of confirmation is quite problematic, as we saw in the full view. I will now go ahead and show all activities and all transitions. And maybe I will also jump back to the average duration. And this here is something that I might also want to have a closer look at because, yeah, maybe I only want to see cases where we have this return and maintenance here. So let's just say I also only want to see stuff where we have a return activity. And now I'm down to 18 cases. Well, with this selection or with any other selection else, what I could also do is I could go ahead and start an animation. Now, so let's say I want, for this 18 cases, I want to see how they're going through the process. So I can click on animation and we see that now this one will show me all the 18 cases going through the process, yeah, flowing through the process here. And you see these are the ones, all these bubbles here are the ones that are going through the process. Of course, it's even nicer when I have more complex graphs. So maybe I want to go back a selection to this one and then say maybe group by month. And we see that now all these cases are flowing through the process here, moving through the process. And if I have bottlenecks like the call of confirmation here, where they are waiting a very long time. And if we have a lot of cases at the same time there, we will also see these bottlenecks within the animation. And so that's quite a nice way of visualizing the process using this animation here. Okay, let me stop it and go back to the other selection that we had here and maybe jump back to the next page where we have more information here, because what I want to show you is the possibility of creating multiple hierarchies within the process. So we have this process here where we have all these activities, and I've so many activities, so many transitions, that it's very hard for me to get into the process at first glance, and I want to group them, have multiple hierarchies, and go from the most general hierarchy down to the most detailed one after another while creating filters and all these hierarchies. Then I can go ahead and say, in this case, we just have this one group. We'll go ahead and say, group this one, show me all of the activities and transitions. And I will see these are the same 1677 cases as in the picture before, but now with the grouped activities. And if I hover over the order process, for example, you will see that the order process consists of kind of the inquiry, order, order confirmation, and quotation. So four activities within this one group. I have the full costs or the average costs for all activities combined within this group, and can now go ahead and say, okay, I only care about the ones with the maintenance and return step, filter based on this hierarchy. I see that I now only look at 52 cases left, 52 cases here. And now I can switch back to my detailed view, show all of the activities and transitions, have this one here, and then maybe go ahead and also create a filter on this level of the hierarchy. You see here it's the other way around. So I have the reminder activity, and the reminder activity is part of the payment process. Filter based on this one, and then we see we have only these two activities selected. Maybe going back to the view before, if I want to have a real closer look at these 52 activities, I can of course jump into a table, show me all the cases directly from the event log, look into everything here. What we also can do is we have this case or variance analyzer where you can jump into all the different cases or variants here. We see that now we have all the different variants here being set up. So for all the different variants, we list all the different variants for the current selection, put information on all these variants, and of course now combine this again, create a filter on these variants here. Say I want to have that selection and have a different view of all the variants with additional information per variant. You can also have this per cases and not per variants. If you want to really have a detailed look at all the cases, then it's also possible to set up here. Also something that you want to have a look at in many processes, if you're analyzing problems, you want to have a closer look at rework. You want to have a closer look at loops within the processes. That's something that we are directly calculating within our scripts, within the transformation of the data that we are doing up front, of course, directly within Qlik Sense. So you can use all the standard connectors that you have. You can combine your data load scripts with the ones that we offer and really integrate your process data into your existing Qlik Sense reports. Also on this page here, we see we have difference between the loops and self-loops within the process. If I go ahead and show all of the activities and transitions again, we see that we have this self loop here, for example, yeah, where we have an order confirmation directly followed by an order confirmation within the same case. It took 20 minutes or 20 minutes later, we had the second order confirmation again. But of course, we have these normal loops where we have multiple activities and then are coming back to an activity that we've already performed within this one case. Well, so maybe what we now want to do is we want to create filters for having a closer look at specific loops within our process. So let's say we want to have something like where we had a shipment and also later on a maintenance. Then of course we can do this by just in this case here, because only just this one path really what you need to filter. We could just click this one or select multiple activities and say, okay, it should have maintenance and reminder, but we are not able to really create something like a BPMN styled filter within this visual. Yeah, that's what we have our events filter for. We reset this one. And let's say we really want to have something like, it should start with an inquiry. It should have shipment. Yeah, so having inquiry followed by shipment at any point. Yeah, not directly. If I put it directly, you see I'm not able to create a filter anymore. Inquiry, that at any point afterwards comes shipment, and then I either want to have a maintenance or maybe it should have a normal reminder. Let's just build up something like this so that we see what we are capable of building. Yeah, so it should start with inquiry. Let's say start with inquiry, have payment at any point, and then either maintenance or reminder. Now that's this one that we are looking here. So see, we have maintenance exists in 29% of the case, because the other ones are here where we have reminder. And so it's this or thing here. What we could also do is that we put it to all paths are matched. So meaning that we had maintenance, also maintenance has been performed and reminder has been performed. We don't care about the order. In our demo here, it's always going to be maintenance first and then reminder afterwards, but it could also be reminder and then we have maintenance. So this one's for parallel processes where you care about the first part has been performed and the second part has been performed. So this is our events filter here. Of course, you could also switch to the grouped view, yeah, and then work with our grouped activities here and not with the detailed activities if you want. Of course, you are also able to work with automation rates. And we are also capable of getting that information or using that information from the event log, use it within the reports, and then have stuff set up like we want to have the activity cost per activity when it was automated and what we saved when it was automated, and then the activity costs in the times where it has not been automated yet, maybe. So have that set up here. We see that on each activity we have an automation rate, and then we also have a color scale set up based on the value that the activity value has, so the automation rate. Yeah, so 0 to 40% is going to be red, 40 to 70% as we have here is going to be yellow, and then we have everything above is going to be green. Yeah, so set up color scales like this. You can have them in any way, as you can have them in all the other Qlik Sense extensions based on the value of that measure, of that value. Yeah. Another great thing is the possibility to benchmark your processes. Yeah, so compare your processes based on different information. We just have our normal process information here. We don't have any kind of additional information like product categories, regions, vendors, or whatsoever. It's just this normal process information. So we are only able to compare, for example, March, everything that started in March compared to everything that started in December. So based on this time information. So everything in March on the left side, everything on December on the right side, showing all the activities and transitions again, maybe. So then we see, okay, we had a duration for cases of 87 days when they started in March, 43 days when they started in December. Show the duration as the main value here, and then really can have a visual comparison based on these different categories, different values that we put onto the pages. Of course, we can have that more automated and then really compare what are the problems for category A compared to category B. All right. This page here has been set up so that we can use our target process within the process analyzer visual. Now you see this little icon here where it says target process filter. You see that the process is colored in green at the moment. I will show all activities and transitions again. And by the way, you can set this so that it will also automatically show the full graph at any time, but I've not set it up that way. So that's why I always need to drag it to 100%. So that we now see the full process again, we see this green path, this green activity, meaning these variants are our target process variants. Yeah, they have been selected. The same case, the first and second variant in our case here should be the target process. Of course, we can also build it up directly in the data model, load it from anywhere directly in the data model from any BPMN software, so that you really have that based on your data and what you already have set up. And then, yeah, this visual highlighting is the one part. And then I can also, of course, say, show me every case that is deviating from the target process at any point. Yeah, doing this, we will then see, for example, the rework rate goes up quite a lot when only looking at cases that are deviating from our target process. And something that you might have also seen is that we have these dotted lines here. If I say I don't care about the auto confirmation, then we have this view of showing the target process how it should have been, or the process how it should have been performed. Yeah, so we should have inquiry and quotation and auto confirmation, for example, but it's not within the currently selected cases. Yeah, that's why we are showing it in this way. Or this one means, yeah, it was performed, but it shouldn't have performed. And here everything is how we expected it to be. This, of course, we can also combine with the benchmarking page and then say, how is it when it goes through the target process compared to when it's not through the target process? And what are the problems? What are the activities that are problematic? All right. This was just, like I said, a very short demo so that you have a brief overview of what is possible. If you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with us. We are always happy to provide you with a trial license that you can play around with your own data and experience process mining in Qlik Sense, at your own Qlik Sense environment.